Once an old Driscoll, always an old Driscoll. What's your problem? I already proved my...
Well, all you proved is, how quickly you'll turn on your friends.
No, it ain't like that. I only rode with them for a while.
Yeah, you might have Dutch fooled. But, I'm watching you.
Well done, Arthur. You found the Irish Terrier. Sadly, he's just a younger version of you.
Please don't say that to me, Dutch.
Oh, it's true. It's true. What you preparing for?
The greatest of gifts.
An unguarded stagecoach.
No, you simple-minded fool. Bison.
Bison?
Bison. From which you can get anything. There's some over on the plains, I believe. I saw a couple a long way off.
Oh. Huh? Good luck.
You want to come with me? I'll show you how we hunt one.
Sure. Why not?
Mount up, then. Let's go.
You know, it was before my time, of course, but my mother used to tell me stories of how her tribe moved with the bison. They lived almost as one. The bison went, my people went. And they were the center of all life. We couldn't survive without them. They provided us with everything. Food, clothing, shelter, tools. There was a lot of respect.
Huh. I don't remember much of my childhood. But I think my people, well, we pretty much moved with the whiskey.
Well, my father did that too. Let's try over here, to the left.
Thank you.
see them all?
Incredible, aren't they? We should only kill one of them. I'll keep them ringed in and you see if you can bring one down. Okay? Clean as you can.
Okay.
And butcher it. Take the horns, too. It can all be used.
You're all right, boy. Hold on.
Good job. Stow that on your horse and mount up. I wanna go check something out.
Okay, let's go. Where are we going?
I thought I saw some scavenger birds over here. Just wanted to see what attracted them. No. Look. Bison. Shot and left for dead, it looks like.
Why would someone do that?
I don't know. But I see tracks heading in this direction. I say we follow them.
All right. Lead the way. Could it have been an animal?
No, they've been shot. I just don't know why anybody would just leave them here to rot like that. Another dead bison, on the hill to the right. Come on. Shot and left for dead again. But this one looks fresher.
There's a camp there. I'm gonna take a look.
Find anything, Arthur?
Haven't gone cold yet. Maybe half a day since they left.
Bison's been dead about the same amount of time.
So what do you want to do?
They could still be in the area. Let's get up higher. See if we spot anything. This way. We should have a good view from up here. See anything?
I see some smoke to the east. Maybe another camp. It's worth a look.
All right. Let's go.
killing for fun.
Think we can talk?
I don't kill for fun. I kill when I need to. Look, more dead bison. It has to be them. Come on.
Wait up!
Did you fools shoot those bison?
What's your problem?
I said, did you fools shoot those bison?
Calm down, you black or red bastard, whatever the fuck you are.
Did you shoot them?
Yes, we did. We shot them bison, we'll shoot you too if you don't get...
What business is it of yours? What? We...
It's that business of mine!
Good God, you're crazy! I got a family. A family. Don't shoot me!
Stand back, Charles. I'll get you some answers.
What the hell are you doing?
Why are you killing those bison and leaving them to rot?
I don't know what you're talking about!
God damn it, tell us or you're dead!
Oh, okay! We were paid to kill as many as we could, and make it look like it was Indians.
Just kill him, Arthur.
No! Please, don't kill me. I'm begging you.
All right, get out of here.
Just don't shoot me, mister. I got a family.
Then run away.
Why did you do that?
He didn't need to die. Maybe he'll go tell his friends now what happens to poachers.
I've seen enough of this. I'm heading back.
Okay. I'm gonna see if there's anything worth taking from their camp. I'll catch up with you later. What?
With good people, Seamus, and I work in the right way.
Well, they all say that. I never met an idiot that called himself one.
Very true. In that case, I'm an idiot. But I know how to get things done efficiently. Look at me. Why would I lie about this?
This is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes us.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said. Keep your voices down. I don't want my boss hearing. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen. He's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur!
Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now you go get that. And then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin. By marriage. I also want to see if you boys got what it takes. Now, you survive that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmody Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I'd love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
Oi. Yep, yep. Really?
Really. Lead the way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Well, clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus's old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
So what's the story with that Emerald Ranch? You find out anything else?
A little. Owner's a nasty type by all accounts. Seamus is sure scared of him.
That's not saying much.
Something strange about the place. Used to be a saloon there, general store. Now it's all closed up, but they seem to have money.
Sounds worth a look around.
For sure. Seamus also mentioned the rancher's daughter a couple of times. How he used to see her around all the time, but now she never leaves the house. Probably just sweet on her.
That what you call finding out a little?
Once he opens up, seems Seamus does like to talk.
Hopefully not too much.
Be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on. There's the house. I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there. Okay, let's take a quick look at the place. You've got binoculars, don't you?
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we can do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show while you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Let's wait.
Okay, let's go.
Sure.
You go into the house. I'll go find this wagon. Maybe take a peek through the windows before you go in. Make sure it's all quiet. Get on, dear boy. Everything we needed.
And I'm pretty sure they never even knew I was there.
Yes, way. Less problems the better right now. Just need to get this back to Seamus in one piece and it's a good night's work. So what were you able to lift from the house?
A few bits and pieces. Nothing too fancy.
Well, we need anything we can get right now.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly, anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Yeah, exactly. How long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Until we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did in Blackwater. Even if we had to dump the money from the ferry, we could have at least got the rest out if it was hidden someplace else.
No, I think we've learned our lesson there. And a few other lessons besides.
I hope so, but I ain't so sure about that.
So, here's something strange. Seamus was telling me how he also makes these little trinkets for people from animal claws, teeth, and such like. Good luck charms.
What, like a rabbit's foot?
I suppose, but he was claiming they really do work.
Don't they all?
Oh, ye of little faith. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there.
Yeah.
Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly.
Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for them. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure.
Looks like you did a bit of hunting.
Now this, I can work with. Well done, Mr. Morgan. Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Thank you.
Who wants to play some poker?
Okie dokie.
If we had a couple of ice-cold beers, it'd be perfect.
My uncle used to play this. Made me promise not to tell my father.
I'll check. I'm just here for fun, all right?
Careful, money bags.
Call.
I fold.
At least it's something.
Not just a little wager.
I'd suggest you make a bolder play than that next time. Let's start with this.
Well, okay.
Cast your eyes on this.
Oh, you gotta be joking.
I like that.
Ah, bullshit.
Uh-huh. Not bad, I guess. By the way, has anybody seen my compass?
I didn't know you had one.
Yeah, I had it since my first day in the Navy. Can't believe I'd gone and lost it.
Well, keep my eye out for another one.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. You know, the amount we move around, it's a useful thing to have. Huh.
I know. It ain't too exciting.
Looks like we got a snake here.
Okay.
I'll call. How about this?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
There's no way you got all that.
I'll see.
Let's start with this.
I'm a call.
No!
Well, gotta get back on the horse.
Ah! Not bad, huh?
There. Nothing.
Get your hankies, right, fellas.
Shoot!
Ah! Woo! Oh, that's a decent hand.
Mm-hmm. Woo! Come to Papa!
Someone's gonna have to make a liquor run eventually.
Nah, I fold.
Don't be too scared now.
Let's have a little fun, shall we?
Hey, now, just take it easy, fella.
Very brave.
Here, just a little.
Matt, gotta play it safe.
I'ma play slow.
Oh, cool,
the hell is
man.
That?
That's it.
Well, look what this old man's got. Things look mighty stacked against you there. Now this is all right.
Damn!
Uh-huh. Look at that!
There's a lot of good game around the Heartlands. We should eat well if people actually get out and do some hunting. I'd rather play for cigarettes than money, really.
I'm gonna go all in.
All right. All right, then.
Yes, sirree.
Now, here's a respectable bet.
Long way to go on a whole heap of nothing.
Oh, hell.
Ain't that sweet?
Not much. Well, you're real lucky.
Damn it.
Well done.
Okay.
I'm out of money. Pearson.
Hello. How are you?
I'm all right. Thanks for asking.
Good for you.
I'm about to pass out.
You busy, Arthur?
Hey, Arthur!
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border.
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure. But what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
Did John mention this train job?
He did. Sounds promising.
Yeah. We're getting things set up now. Yep. Yep.
Hey,
Come on now, boy.
Okay, boy. Thank you.
You're done, boy.
Jesus.
Time to go, boy.
Hey, partner.
Yeah.
Hey there.
Ha ha ha!
Arthur! Mr. Arthur! Why are you always so mad? You're crazy! All that shooting!
Nice to see you again, sir.
Hard.
Hello.
So that train that got robbed up in the Grizzlies had Mr. Cornwall's car on, apparently. Well, I'm glad you're doing the right thing.
Thank you for your help. Mister?
Hello?
Howdy.
All right, stranger.
Hi. Who needs a ride? I can get you where you want to go.
Hello, mister.
Hey, howdy, sir.
Come on now, get moving, will
you? Hey, boy. Calm down. Sorry. No, I'll stop it now.
Keep going.
Sorry. I'll stop messing with you now. That's my boy.
Son of a bitch!
Shit!
Shoot him! Ah!
ain't moving.
Yeah. job. Get.
Hey there, partner.
Dumb is dumb. I ain't warning you again.
Thank you.
Come on, pal.
Hey, mister. I just want to be left alone, all right?
A sentiment I'm familiar with. Fair enough, kid.
Holding hands with that dump. Come on, kid.
You care about this girl? Stand up for yourself. She'll come around.
Yeah? I've been waiting.
Trust me, kid. There ain't so many good men out there. Make yourself one of the good ones.
Thanks, mister. I hope you're right.
You wait, Lily Mae. Well, someday, I'll show you. I'll be rich. A nice big house.
Hey there, mister.
All right, then.
Actually, forget about it.
Fine. Happy to be done with it.
That ain't good enough.
Hello.
For you. Here it is. Fork over what you got. You ain't getting no more water. Put some horns.
Ah!
Thank you.
outfit.
Out of the way!
What cargo are you bringing through here?
Easy there. I'm trying to get these supplies to the federal building. It's on the knee.
Federal ain't got no authority here.
We'll be taking them goods for the citizens of Lemoyne.
Hey, Hey, boy.
What are you doing here?
Show them who's boss.
You can burn in hell. Friend.
You're a goner.
Yep. Take that something down, y'all.
Yeah.
Get in the way, damn it.
Now, boy, there's a
need. Get away.
Done.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good morning, Arthur.
Could really use some good meat for this stew.
Don't you overcook this now, Pearson.
Not the best quality, but some seasoning will hide it.
Miss Grimshaw.
Hi there.
Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
Many thanks, Mr. Morgan.
Hey, fellas.
Hey there.
How are you?
Good morning, Arthur.
You'll work it out, Dutch. You always do.